bad moment. I always said that. So last week, we took a look at the most lovely performance you've ever seen. This week, we're going to be doing something different. We're going to be looking at the top 11 most underrated teams. Most of these videos are top 10s, but somebody, copy, decided to put the only lists that were top 11 right next to each other and at the very beginning. Thanks, copy. So, what are underrated teams? These are improv teams that they might not have, like, won a lot, but they were just hilarious, and they made you smile. They just didn't get the attention they deserved. So we're going to make some wrong things right by doing that right now. Here are the top 11 underrated teams.
There was no safety barrier for them. If they wanted to do a piggyback ride during the scene, they were going to do the piggyback ride. If they were going to jump off the stage, they were going to do it. It wasn't a question of if, but when something of that was going to happen.
Their craziness lives in my heart forever and ever. And I just remember flinching every time they would do a flip or fall or break their arm or break their leg or break any body part. And I would it was just incredible to watch them perform. And
if you want to do a shock value or leaving an audience remembering who they are and just enjoying what they do, that was Southwest, man. Wins and losses aside, sometimes that just doesn't matter. And those Southwest boys created memories.
It was definitely a great experience. Just kind of getting a few people on stage, kind of like playing some games, having fun, kind of branching out, learning new things. That's pretty much what improv's all about. And we might not have won a championship, but we definitely had fun. And in that regard, I think of us as all winners.
Cowan, as a team, had a lot of potential to do a lot more damage in the league and be a threat. The year that we showed up with our bright green shirts, I tried to make sure that everyone could see how smart and talented these kids were.
Cowan had so much ridiculous talent. I don't think they ever knew it. They had countless performers on that team that would have been assets to a lot of other teams. They had abilities, they were funny, they actually worked pretty well together. That's 100% an underrated team.
They ended up with a really good record. We didn't do so well in the playoffs, but I think if we had more time together, we could have really won a championship or two.
Cowan was awesome because it took a lot of misfits going into one place and coming together and being able to use improv as an outlet for each other. We were all for each other. We made sure we had rides, made sure that we were taken care of, and really acted like a family. And I think from that experience, it really uplifted my spirits when I was going through a really dark time.
Yeah, I think from top to bottom, all those kids are stars.
Taking a ragtag bunch of kids who before the season didn't have a lot of, you know, interaction with each other, and then throwing them together and putting them show after show, it really kind of did something to them special.
We didn't have anyone to rotate, and every show, every person on the team was available to go maybe all the way out to Blue Diamond, or like all the way out here, or like all the way out to Basic, and we just didn't care. It was just kind of like it was a passion for us, and I didn't know if I appreciated that enough when we were doing it. I just thought it was a given, and I can't be more grateful for that.
Those four, week after week, show after show, had to basically come in every single week, and they did, and they grew, and they became such a good team. They were so close by the end of it.
By the end of the year, it actually turned into a cohesive little unit. And yeah, they had Big Zarek on there, who had a giant personality, but ultimately, the rest of that team, man, just, you would think they were scared of their own shadows. And you know what? I don't even know if that was the case. I think that it's just who they are as people are just not giant, big performers. They only had one, and that was Eric.
They had fun, they did their thing, and they loved Jesters. What more can you ask for?
I mean, I'm so happy they're on the underrated group list because they deserve it. They're amazing, they try really hard, and we don't get a lot of time together. And I'm just amazing with the kids I've gotten to teach and how they pick up what I teach them in the last 2 years.
And I just feel like we really worked together so well, and our dynamic was so nice. Like, we always knew what we were all thinking. And like, even if like we haven't thought about it yet, like, we knew. Like, we just knew it was gonna work. Like, we all fit together really well. There's so much passion just involved with our team, everyone on it. Everyone loves being there, and they put their heart and soul into it. And even if we lose like a game that doesn't even count, everyone is like super like upset about it. Not just because like, oh, we lost or whatever. They're just upset with themselves because they said, I can do better. And that's a big part of our review, is that they've always are trying to do better, and they're trying to become these best performers, and they care about giving their best performance at that time, in that moment with those people. And I love my team so much.
Alyssa, man, from the second she started, is a force. Emma transferring in there. Vinny, man, wow. The best little cherry on top you could have. And then just a rotating group of people that could have been that fourth, from Tulip to Faith to Kayla. I mean, there were a bunch. Arborview as a whole, really solid squad. They didn't need a championship to know that. They were 100% a team.
I'm the tribal kid, so I didn't do it much in the beginning, and then eventually you guys just opened me up to it, and the more fun I had, the more I wanted to keep doing it. Johnny was always a good person, just because he wanted to try everything, and he's like, well, let's do this, let's try this, let's see what this, and he was a very good team leader. Kels just pushed me because she was my sister, so she wanted me to always be a part of it, because she was like, you're gonna be a lonely little kid if you don't open up. So that was always fun. Kevin was just very excited about everything. He was very eager just to play any game, to have fun, and just be with everyone.
We killed it that year. We just had so much energy. I don't know, we were all really close too, and always did improv after school together, and I had a great time working with them, playing some improv games.
I remember even playoff time thinking, man, this is a team that could and should win some shows here. And they ultimately didn't, but Kyle ended up being a force in the league for years. Johnny, we knew how good he was. Kelsey, man, like, Kelsey's lighting up the world. Kelsey might be one of the most successful after Jesters there is. That was a squad, man. I would have put them up against a lot of teams. Talk about what it could have, should have been, man. You're talking about Kyle Gurdon, who every year was a beast, freshman, senior. You're talking about Connor, Corey, and young Megan Sweeney, who's an MVP nominee. They had a giant team. They had just a whole slew of other performers. But those four, plus their supporting cast, this is a team that easily should have made it to the championship. Like, that's how good I think this team was. Wins and losses sometimes don't tell the story. I'm telling you right now, that team arguably could have beat some championship teams. Well, that's how good they could have been.
I just remember that was my dream team. I remember teaching Connor and teaching Megan, and Corey was already in Jesters, so he already had a taste of it and was just hungry for it.
So 2016, that was many moons ago. That was when Connor and I were like the go-to duo at Centennial. Like, we had like the slap stomp thing, and it was I know it was very fun. There was never a dull moment, but of course I had to be like the girl of the team, and I had to like keep the boys in check, but that just meant goofing off, telling puns, and like fighting in the green room.
To be honest, we just went for it. We really didn't know what our game plan was, as some improv teams should have. They should have a game plan, but we just all we wanted to do, because we were the guinea pig team.
I loved watching how much Desi, as a freshman, was clearly paying attention and listening and learning and absorbing as much as he could. He didn't have the tools yet to put himself completely out there like he eventually would become, but being around a kid like JJ totally fed that creativity, taught him quietly how to go from being just somebody in the background who contributes here or there where they can, to being that all-encompassing performer. And JJ, truly one of the most underrated in the league ever, you know.
It's a lot of good talent and a lot of what improv needs, because 80% of improv is garbage, people. Not always good, but you get those one-liners and you get some of those really good team-building things, and I'm just really happy for my team because we loved each other, man. It was great.
I mean, they were good enough, man. Always. Always good enough every year. But if you just want to talk underrated, we didn't know that 2015 team was good. We had no idea. It was 2016 when we were like, okay, watch out for Cimarron. 2015 definitely deserves some love.
That's what jump-started my love for improv, but as that first team.
The 2013 Desert Oasis team was full of giants, man. Like, Sega was so good in his own right. Like, he made weird choices, but they were always funny. Kovach, he was more clever than almost any other jester I can think of. Kyle was somebody that we'd had for years, and we'd seen him grow. And his style was just all charisma. It was charisma. It was fun choices. I mean, talent wise, he was at the top of the charts. Jorge, extremely solid player who could have put him on any team and he would have thrived. That team was so good.
Like, they were so polarizingly different. It just worked. It absolutely worked.
We were a four-team dream squad. We were the Beatles if they somehow never got famous and somehow the Monkees rose up above them. We had Kyle coming in with most hilarious openers, never afraid to step in. We had Jorge, could always come in second, follow whatever you were doing, jump around, be happy, be laughable. You had me coming in third, adding nuance to the scene, going where it could go, driving the story forward. And you had Kovach coming in for the slammer, coming in and body slamming the audience with unexpected twists and turns. We were robbed. Our first playoff round, we got the only bye, and we had the most wins during the season. So, you know, if the dice were rolled out differently, wouldn't it be with that Jester's championship ring right now?
The 2016 Bonanza team was a team that should not have won any playoff games. Like, they just, if you saw the team at the beginning of the year, there was potential, there was this or that. It didn't seem like a team that could develop. And then they put the work in.
Towards the beginning of my season, Brent Bukai, he provided a little constructive criticism that sometimes I may overtake a scene. And that was something that my team helped me with a lot. So not only were they a bunch of funny guys, but the girls, guys, a bunch of funny people, they helped me grow as a comedian, and I think that is the best thing you can ask from a team.
Our 2016 team, they were really strong, and I feel like it was probably because we had the different years and we had different experiences. Like, me and Clackham have been, you know, we were 2 years, and then we had Jason, who was just starting off, and then Royce, who ended up being a one and done. It was just a very good mixture of people and a very good mixture of actors and actresses that were...
I mean, I'm always going to be so proud of that team. For them to be so close to that championship and to have to go through one of the best teams of all time, I mean, man. And to give them a run for their money, I'm so proud of those kids. I'm so proud of that team. But they'll be underrated for sure.
Was probably our most talented team throughout. Everyone who went to Jesters all had something about them that could be like really good in a show. That's why our coach Karina had such a hard time picking the team, the playoff team mostly.
And when we're on stage, we all come together and just we take on one story. And we all bonded and we all like laughed over everything and we had our moments. And it's just we're a really strong team when we're together.
I think until the final four, I think every show I watched Durango do in 2018, they were the better team.
And so our year at Durango, everyone just kind of blossomed.
It's so easy to say why 2018 Durango is number two. They had a coach that was 18. Like fresh out of high school, and that coach only did 1 year Jesters. They had the first ever freshman MVP nominee. They had all the talent. They graduated some seniors, but if they were that good, that makes me excited for what Durango is to come. So, hands down, underrated.
I was there that year. Are you sure that they? I don't remember them being that good. Yeah, those teams are great, but I kind of forgot who some of them were, so let's do a recap of number 11 through 2.
I'm gonna miss them so much. I think that for only being a second year team and making it to the final four this year, I couldn't have asked for a better senior year, especially with improv and everything. And I know I'm leaving my team in good hands with Sydney as a coach.
They really, really made me a better performer, or made my perspective as performing better. And they were just humble, they had a lot of energy, and they really just wanted to do improv, which I really appreciated. So I think when they went as far as they did and how focused they were, I was surprised, but I also wasn't, just because of how dedicated they were to it. And every show, it was just, how can I get better? What did we do wrong? What did we do right? So naturally, I think they deserved it and they worked really, really hard for it.
I remember when I started coaching them, and I realized that they were so much more talented than I could ever be, and I was like, well, I don't know how this is gonna work. I don't know how I'm gonna like teach these people, like, who are teaching me more, like, anything.
We had a coach this year in 2018 that was also 18, a different coach, first year out of high school. They had a bunch of, they had a giant team that in the beginning of the year, they started off with a fight. Me personally, I had to sit the team down and talk them through a fight. An hour long fight of crying and swearing and problems and you name it, turned into a team that produced such a good product on stage. My hat completely goes off to Sydney, their coach. My hat goes off to that entire team. They went in there, made it to the Final Four, took Tua Khan to the absolute limit. That Tua Khan basic Final Four show was a fight. It was an absolute fight. That basic team, no one ever saw coming. Hands down, the most underrated team we've ever had in the league.
There's nothing basic about that team. So, unfortunately, that concludes all the time we have for today on our Jesters video. Please tune in next Monday for the top 10 wow moments. Is it top 10? I think, yeah, it's top 10. Top, just moments that make us go, did that just happen? Like making a basic pun. All right, Jester later.